Iran launched a solid-fuel rocket into space, drawing a rebuke from Washington ahead of the expected resumption of the stalled talks over Tehran's nuclear deal with the world powers. This rocket launch shows that Iran literally has the potential to manufacture its own ICBM because their technologies are almost the same. The Zuljanah Satellite Carrier, which was successfully launched from Iranian Aerospace Center, had a covered message for Tehran's opponents. This satellite carrier is a three-stage rocket that uses both solid and liquid fuel engines. The rocket is able to carry cargo weighting up to 220 kilograms and reach height of 500 kilometers. The US has argued that such satellite launches are signs that Iran is developing its nuclear program, as these launch vehicles incorporate technologies that are virtually identical to those used in ballistic missiles designed to be capable of carrying nuclear weapons. The solid propellant stages used by Zuljanah could be used in future ICBM to deliver payloads of about 500 kilograms to ranges of at least 4,000 kilometers. Islamic Republic of Iran in recent years has launched multiple satellite carriers into space, and this last one involved their most advanced satellite and also rocket technologies. Iran's leader has numerously said that this country doesn't want to make nuclear weapon or even doesn't need to have ballistic missiles with ranges more than 2,500 kilometers, as their current missiles are enough to reach their enemies, which obviously indicates to Israel. This attitude is somehow Tehran's policy not to provoke Europeans and also Asian counterparts because of the ICBM technology. But new international political realities may have also changed Tehran's point of view in this direction. They still don't want any nuclear weapon or intercontinental ballistic missile to carry a nuclear warhead, but are getting ready to manufacture those things immediately in case the West doesn't reach a deal with Tehran. In their opinion, they have been under Western pressure for decades and have endured unprecedented political and economic pressure for what they have always claimed that they don't really want to make. Now, if negotiations don't bear fruitful economic results for Tehran, they may finally choose to get what they have given so much for. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe. And don't forget to write your opinion down in the comments.